In this hands-on lesson, we're going to create an AWS config rule that looks for any security group rules that allow access from any source address to port numbers other than port 80. Port 80 is fine. Obviously, we want people to be able to connect to our websites from the internet, but otherwise we're wide open. So that might be something that we want from a compliance perspective to restrict. So what we'll do is have config looking for compliant and non-compliant resources, and then SSM automation, so systems manager automation, will be used to remediate any non-compliant resources. In the course download in the AWS config directory, we have this config rule and remediation document. And so here we've got the general process of what we're going to do. Firstly, we'll create an IAM role for systems manager, and it's going to have this policy attached to it. We'll also add an inline policy with the code from this document, automation iamrole.json. Then we'll create a config rule using one of the managed rules in AWS config and use port 80 as the authorized TCP port. Then we'll add the remediation configuration. So let's go and get started. Back in AWS, I'm going to head to the Identity and Access Management service. Let's pop that on my favorites. And I'm going to create a role. Click on Create Role, AWS Service, and I'm going to look for Systems Manager. Here it is. I'll leave the default Systems Manager. Click on Next. I'm going to look for that policy, which was in the Markdown file, the instructions, Amazon SSM Automation Role. This gives us a variety of permissions to EC2. We can see CloudFormation in there. So let's click on Next. Give this role a name. I'm going to call it Amazon SSM Automation Role, same as that policy document. And let's create that role. So the role has been created. Now I'm going to search for the role, select the role, and on the permissions tab, I'm going to create an inline policy. Click on JSON, and let's go and find that code. We want to add this code here. This is going to allow the action revoke security group ingress. So let's pop back to the editor here, delete out the code, and save that one in. Click on Next, give the policy a name, revoke ingress SG, and create the policy. Okay, so now we have the role configured. Next, let's head over to AWS config, open that up in a new tab. We have this one-click setup, let's do that. And just click on Confirm. That's just set up some default settings for us. Okay, now on the left-hand side, we can click on Rules, Add Rule, and we want to add a managed rule. Now let's come back here to the instructions, and we can see we're looking for this particular rule here. So let's copy that name and search. And so it's found this rule for us, VPC SG open only to authorized ports. Checks if security groups allowing unrestricted incoming traffic only allow inbound TCP or UDP connections on authorized ports. The rule is non-compliant if such security groups do not have ports specified in the rule parameters. That's exactly what we want. So let's go through and have a look at the settings that we need to apply. We can see this is going to apply to EC2 security groups. Here we have the authorized TCP ports. I want to authorize port 80. I don't have any UDP ports. That's optional anyway. Then let's click on Next and save. Now I'm going to click on the rule, go to Actions and Manage Remediation. I'll click on Choose Remediation Action, and to find this more easily, you can find it under here, so aws-disablePublicAccessForSecurityGroup. Let's paste that in. There it is. Scroll down a little way, and now we have to specify some details. For resource ID parameter, we're going to specify group ID. For IP address to block, we're going to put in 0.0.0.0/0. For automation assume IAM role, we will add the ARN for the role that we created previously. So let's copy the ARN here and paste this in, and then save changes. Now that's all set up. It can take a few minutes. So what I'm going to do is open EC2 here. Let's go and find some security groups and make sure that we do have other ports in security groups. For example, my web access security group here likely has inbound rules such as SSH from anywhere. In fact, we've got a few here. We've got ICMP, we've got RDP, we've got SSH. The only one that's going to be allowed is port 80 HTTP. The other ones, in theory, should be removed. That's what we're trying to aim for. If we come back to config, what we can do is click on reevaluate here. And then if I go back up to rules, we can see, oh, we've got one non-compliant resource. And we can see here, resources in scope, non-compliance, and it's discovered those port numbers that were non-compliant. So I've selected the resource, and let's go ahead and manually click on remediate to get things moving. And it says the action execution is queued. Shouldn't take too long, and we'll be able to go and check and refresh our security group rules, and hopefully it's removed those rules for us. So let's head over to security groups, click on refresh, and sure enough, the number of rules has just reduced. It hasn't picked up on ICMP because it was looking for TCP. Interestingly, it hasn't got the 8181. I'm not sure the reason for that, but it has removed the SSH and RDP, which were both allowing access from any source address. So it looks pretty successful to me. Let's come back to rule details here. I don't want to leave this remediation action in place, so I'm going to remove the remediation action and then delete my rule. And that's not going to prevent me anymore from adding those rules in where I need them.